I think it's important that human beings realize that they're humans first and then workhorses after is not the inverse order. Well, I'm part American, part Danish. So my father's American, my mother is Danish. But I grew up most of the time here in Denmark. Although, of course, a lot of my education was in the U.S. My mother is a high school teacher, and my father is a civil engineer. Worked at the Technical University of Denmark. So I was brought up between humanities and the natural sciences and technology. I think my father had some expectations as to what I was going to be. I mean, he would much love to see me being an academic, especially of a natural science nature or technology nature or even finance or economics. I think my mother was more lenient in that respect. I liked the natural sciences in high school. I did also like the humanities and social sciences. So I needed to find a field which could sort of cater to both interests or three interests. And philosophy was just lying around there as a very pretty obvious choice. Insofar as to say you can go very technical in philosophy. There's a lot of mathematics and logic, even philosophy of physics on one end. And then there is the humanities part is also catered to, right, in terms of epistemology. And there's also questions of, you know, existential issues, et cetera, et cetera. So philosophy was a pretty obvious choice. I think the best advice I got is it's 10% talent and the rest is just hard work. I mean, semper ardens means always burning. And so, in any field, but in this particular field also, I think my greatest challenge is that you spend a lot of hours on it, but it'll never be worth a life. It's a job. David Hume, a very famous British philosopher, once said, be a philosopher, but amidst your philosophy, be a man. That means be human. This is not worth a life. My son Milton, he asked me in 2008, I received the Elite Research Prize, which is the biggest science prize that you can receive in Denmark. So the morning I was going to go in and receive the prize, he asked me two questions. One is, what is it that you do? Which is a pretty good question in by itself. However, the follow-up is even better. Why is it important? Why is it important? Now, I got the Elite Research Prize for some very complicated topological, mathematical models of particular kinds of knowledge, etc. I had maybe 2.5 readers a paper. But when he popped me that question, I was like, well, how can I take these tools, and use them to better humanity? I mean, isn't science, the purpose of science is also that. If my science can be part of curating and understanding the information market, the attention economics, the bubble phenomena, in such a way that misinformation becomes less of a problem, then that's my goal. Then that's why it's important.